The Vivekananda Samiti IIT Kanpur is a student body that has been working for the dissemination and actualization of the teachings of Swami Vivekananda for the last four decades by motivating the youth community towards the path of human excellence. Vivekananda Youth Leadership Convention 2014 aims to inspire the students to imbibe and assert values of self-belief, fearlessness, perseverance, and above all, service to humanity. This VYLC includes talks by eminent leaders, workshops, school and college competitions, and cultural programs. Today's session is on leadership and social entrepreneurship. In today's session, we have two speakers, Mr. Anshu Gupta and Mr. Shobhit Mathur. However, Mr. Anshu Gupta could not be with us today due to health issues. So I take this opportunity to welcome our esteemed guest for today, Mr. Shobhit Mathur, who is the National Organizing Secretary of Youth for Seva. Mr. Mathur completed his Bachelor's in Computer Science in 2004 from IIT Bombay and Master's from the University of Washington in 2006. He was the first fellow of Yuva for Seva, a Seva internship program of Seva International. He returned to India in 2009 and started the Youth for Seva Hyderabad chapter in February 2010 to make Seva as a movement among the youth in Hyderabad. Youth for Seva is a volunteering platform for the youth and is primarily involved in the betterment of education, health awareness, environmental conservation, etc. to create a real lasting change and make the world a better place to live in. I take this opportunity to invite Mr. Shobhit Mathur to address the gathering.
Thank you for inviting me here. It's a privilege to be back at the IIT campus after so many years. And I would say that it's one of the most beautiful IIT campuses I've seen. I've seen Chennai, Mumbai, Delhi, Kanpur. So it's definitely one of the most beautiful ones. So it's very glad to be here, and thanks to Vivekananda Samiti for calling me here. If I had thought about this 10 years back that IIT would call me back to talk to the students, it would be unimaginable, because I was never one of the students who would be talking to others on leadership, social entrepreneurship and topics like that. But things have turned out very different in the past 10 years, and I've taken a different route in life. So I'm glad that I'm back, and it's always exciting to talk to students again. And especially on this occasion, Swami Vivekananda's 150th birthday. I mean, it's an amazing thing, right? This person lived 150 years back and done so much in just 9 years of time, right? He just lived 39 years. He worked for 9 years of his life, and 150 years later, we still remember him. And possibly 150 years later, we still remember him. So, can you imagine the kind of contribution he has done? And it's very humbling to be here and talk on this great occasion of this birthday. So I'll try to keep it English-Hindi mix. Though I'm from Hyderabad, I don't speak very good Hindi, but Hindi mein jo apna pan hai, wo English mein nahi hai. So I'll try to mix it, and I most of you are from the Hindi belt, so all of you will understand Hindi very well. So when Vivekananda Samiti invited me to talk and they said leadership and things like that, I was a little skeptical because I have not done something like this before. So I thought I will title the talk as My Lessons in Life, What I Have Learned. And I'm still learning, so it's going to be a long journey for me. So what I have learned so far, some of it might be relevant to all of you. So that's fine. It's not about talking about my story because I feel I have done a great deal, but because I have done a lot of mistakes and I've learned from those. And what I have done maybe relates to you somewhere. Like for example, Bharat mein this story ka bahut importance hai, right? We remember stories told by a lot of people. There's nothing more inspirational than a story, because story we connect somewhere. If it's a general dry lecture, nobody connects. So I tried to put my life on a story. And aap sabhi log jahan yahan par hai, I'm sure all of you will relate somewhere. Ki haan, this relates to my life somewhere. So takeaway points thode zyada hote jab hum khud ki story bolte hain, theek hai? So I'll try to tell my story. I'll keep a lot of time for questions, because I'm sure you'll have a lot of questions to ask, because the journey is a little interesting. Right, so I just divided my life into a few phases where I believe I some transformational moments, inflection points were there, so where things changed, right? So, of course, born in 82 and in a general middle class family. My dad is a bank officer, he retired. My mom was a school teacher and I had an elder brother. So, 80s mein, jo paida hua hai Bharat mein, they are born in very simple middle class families. Economy is not doing very great and फैमिली का होप यही है कि अगर अच्छा बच्चे पढ़ लिख लेंगे तो जिंदगी में कुछ बन पाएंगे राइट देयर इज नो बिग इन्वेस्टमेंट इन्वेस्टमेंट इज ओनली ऑन एजुकेशन इन दोस इयर्स हाउ मच यू कैन गेट योर चिल्ड्रन एजुकेटेड एस्पेशली इफ यू डोंट हैव अ ग्रेट फैमिली डायनेस्टी टू लिव ऑन सो द फोकस ऑन एजुकेशन एंड एट दैट टाइम देयर इज नो टाइम टू थिंक अबाउट द कंट्री इट्स इश्यूज बच्चा क्या रैंक आया बेटा यही पूछेंगे सवाल एट द एंड ऑफ एकेडमिक ईयर फर्स्ट सेकंड थर्ड आएगा तो खुश वरना डांट पड़ेगी राइट सो इट्स ऑल अबाउट आर यू स्टडीइंग वेल आर यू गेटिंग गुड रैंक इन क्लास दैट्स द क्वेश्चन फॉर्चुनेटली आई डिड वेल ओके एंड आई ऑलवेज डिड बेटर देन अ ब्रदर सो आई गॉट द प्रिविलेज ऑफ बीइंग द गुड बॉय एट होम सो लेट्स गो नेक्स्ट राइट सो टू ग्रेट इंसिडेंट्स हैपेंड इन माय लाइफ इन दोस एंटायर 16 इयर्स Cricket fans will know this. 1996. Yeah, 1996 India-Pakistan quarterfinals. Okay, so this is fun. Okay, just to keep you excited. So we never cared about the country, but our only burst of patriotism came in India-Pakistan matches. Okay, which happens even today, or India-Pakistan wars. So that is the only time you think about the country and forget the next day. So this was actually it's 96. I'm in my 8th grade. Okay, 8th standard. India scores up 272. Okay, people all know how Jadeja hit Pakar Yunus that time. Okay, so and then these guys, the most fearful opening pair, Amir Sohail and Syed Anwar, start hitting, and everybody is scared. And what happens is Venkatesh Prasad bowls Amir Sohail. The whole country is very passionate, and they all shout. So that is patriotism. What we thought at that time, that India should beat Pakistan. And I remember at that young age. After India won the match, we all went on the streets and burst crackers. Okay. So that is one thing. And exactly 4 years later, when the World Cup again happened in England this time, this was happening in Kashmir. Right? It's the Kargil War. People who didn't live through the Kargil War must have seen the movie Laksh. So it relates very closely to the war which happened. But at that time we didn't care much. I mean, it was again, do we beat Pakistan, right? Did we win the war? That's the only patriotism. At that time, if you see an army man, we do salute, we are very proud of him. Next day again we forget about it. I mean it's all over. So this was what I'm saying is the first 16 years of my life. Thinking about society or thinking about the country never happened. It happened only in bursts. In very simple instances like this. And it was always forgotten. Because it's only about studying well and doing well. So of course we worked very hard. At those times, getting into IIT was very, very difficult. Even now, it is very difficult. Very few IITs, not many good engineering colleges across the country. So, if you have to do well in life, you have to get into the IITs. You have to work very hard. And then, you know Hyderabad, you know how the coaching centers work, and we slog. And we made it. Okay, can you go next? So, that is somehow in 2000, we made it to, IIT. I got a very good rank and at that time computer science IIT Bombay was the best. So what you choose, that's what you get. So I got through computer science in IIT and something happened after that. So you can just go next. Right. So all these things came up. Okay. So I had no big exposure because I was from a very protective family. Like at home, simple family, right? I'll tell you what happened the first night when I was at IIT. So my dad comes with me. बेटे को कॉलेज में रुकाना है, एक रात रुकेंगे, ताकि he feels mentally fine. So he's there. In the middle of the night, one of my friends, I'll not take his name, he's here. He comes and knocks on my door and says, "चल ताश खेलते हैं." This is not what I have done in life so far. Yes. And my impression of IIT is यहाँ पर सब पढ़ाकू लोग होते हैं, right? अलग अलग देश से आए, मतलब देश दूसरे पार्ट से आए हैं, पढ़ाई के लिए आए हैं हम लोग, और ये बोलते हैं चल ताश खेलते हैं. सो फॉर मी इट्स वेरी शॉकिंग. ठीक है. एंड देन I chose Bombay. Most of my friends from Hyderabad chose Chennai. That's the first choice people take. So when you choose Bombay, most of the students who come there are from Rajasthan, are from Maharashtra, are from UP, Bihar, and different parts of the country. Typically not the south. South typically goes to Chennai. So totally different culture shock for me. So of course, you know, the gali galoch, all those things. Not being used to any of those things. So I got exposed to a lot of things, and I learned a lot of things. It's very, very important phase of my life because I met different people from different parts of the country. Extremely talented, extremely brilliant, lot of them. I mean, I never faced that kind of a competition in life academically. So, very good. But one more very interesting thing happened in 2000. I mean, this is like 14 years back. It's difficult for you to imagine. Something called the internet came up big time. I mean, before it was there, but it was just there. Koi cyber cafe mein kahin to you can go and access something called email. It was limited to that. Now you get high bandwidth connection in your rooms. Okay. That opens up the world. Matlab, if you are there, you will realize this. I mean, people have seen the smartphone revolution. That's nothing compared to when you get connected to the internet 24/7, high bandwidth. Okay. So we got on there, and then the first thing we do is we download all the stuff. Okay. These are my two favorite movies. I used to watch them so many times. This is favorite sitcoms. A lot of people, I don't know if it's still a fashion today to watch Friends, but we used to watch that. So we did these things. So kya hota hai, when the world gets exposed to you at such rapid pace, matlab mentally main wahan hoon. I mean, I'm learning every day so many things. So too much exposure, too much things, and we have to handle it. माँ बाप पास में नहीं है कुछ क्वेश्चन पूछने के लिए, दोस्त नहीं बनाने पड़ते हैं, हॉबीज नहीं बनाने पड़ते हैं, खुद से समय निकालना पड़ता है पढ़ाई के लिए, खेल के लिए, सब के लिए. सो वी हैंडल सम थिंग्स वेल, वी डोंट हैंडल सम थिंग्स वेरी वेल. सो वी मेड सम मिस्टेक्स विद लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स. तो बट आई लर्न अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स, एंड ऑफकोर्स आई हैव द कंप्यूटर की. आई यूज्ड टू प्ले अराउंड विद समथिंग कॉल्ड रेड हैट लिनक्स 7.6.1 वॉज द वर्जन विच केम अप. आई डोंट नो, अभी आई एम नॉट इन टच विद लिनक्स, बट इट्स गॉन मच फर्दर देन दैट. So we used to do all these things. Ek aur cheez, very interesting thing in my life happened at that time was, fortunately I was good at studies, and my faculty advisor guy jo hota hai IT mein, he sent me to France to do my internship. So now that's like a dream come true. Matlab you don't often get a chance like that. So I just go to a French speaking country jahan pe koi English baat nahi karta hai. And I stayed there for 2 months. Did some work, I did a lot of time pass, a lot of things happened. But I saw the West for the first time. See, they say I saw West. I mean, this is the scene next. Right in front of Eiffel Tower at the night when it's lit up in the lawn there, everybody doing different things. So West ka chaska laga, right? It's like, man, this is beautiful, right? And I already had all this exposure about the movies, Hollywood, these things. I was like a freak watching movies. तो द वेस्ट इज ब्यूटिफुल, जो आज भी कई सारे लोगों के मन में है कि वाइट इज ब्यूटिफुल, वेस्ट इज ब्यूटिफुल, दैट काइंड ऑफ माइंड सेट. तो बहुत ही ज्यादा इट केम इन टू माई हेड. एंड देन बींग फ्रॉम द साउथ, टिपिकली फ्रॉम आंध्र प्रदेश, द अमेरिकन ड्रीम इज द बिगेस्ट ड्रीम. सो यू कैन सी द अमेरिकन ड्रीम, आई पुट द ईगल देयर. सो यू हैव टू सिट ऑन द ईगल एंड फ्लाई टू अमेरिका. इफ यू फ्लाई, इफ यू आर इन अमेरिका, यू हैव मेड इट इन लाइफ. एक बेंच मार्क है सक्सेस का. अमेरिका में कदम रखते हैं तो जन्नत में कदम रखते हैं, लाइक दैट काइंड ऑफ थिंग. अदरवाइज यू आर अ फेलियर इन लाइफ. दिस इज द माइंडसेट. बिकॉज एट दैट टाइम, अनलाइक टुडे, देयर वर नॉट टू मेनी एमएनसीज कमिंग एंड रिक्रूटिंग पीपल एंड डूइंग सिंपल थिंग्स, एंडिंग अप इन द वेस्ट एंड वर्किंग फॉर सम कंपनी, सेंडिंग डॉलर्स होम. दैट इज द बिगेस्ट ड्रीम एनी फैमिली कैन हैव. तो लॉट ऑफ, आई एम सेइंग दिस इज द फेज ऑफ माय लाइफ वेयर आई लर्न लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स, एंड द ह्यूज फैसिनेशन फॉर द वेस्ट केम अप. In the entire IIT batch, there were just a couple of people who didn't sit for placements. And one of them was me, in my batch. Placements ke liye apply bhi nahi kiya. It's very shocking. Matlab, kyun? Because anyway, placements are going to happen for Indian companies, right? So I want to go to the US. So why should I do sit for placements and thapao my brain on interviews and all these things? Rather, I'll apply and I'll get it. And I have fairly good CGPA, jo bolte. So I knew something will happen. So I never even thought about doing these things. But a lot of lessons I learned in IIT, which looking back, I think I should have done better. One is that I was a, kya bolte hai, room mein baitha tha. Like just, I never participated in a lot of cultural activities. I never participated in a lot of sport activities. I was good at literary activities, quizzes, debates, kabhi kabhi, right? All those small things. Hostel mein computer secretary for 2 years, then institute mein bhi kuch computers, I took some roles. But kabhi maine jaakar us time pe main kabhi samjha nahi what is the importance of participating in cultural activities. जो लोगों से मिलने को मिलता है आई हैड अ लॉट ऑफ अपॉर्चुनिटी लॉट ऑफ चांसेस पर कभी भी अवॉइड किया उन चीज़ों को आई हैव मेड सो मेनी अमेजिंग फ्रेंड्स हु आर डूइंग सो मेनी अमेजिंग थिंग्स नाउ वो आईआईटी में रहकर ही हो सकता है बिकॉज ऑल ओवर द कंट्री से लोग आ रहे हैं अमेजिंग जीनियस आई मीन लाइक इंप्रेसिव पीपल सो आई मेड लॉट ऑफ गुड फ्रेंड्स विच आई फेल्ट वॉज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन माई लाइफ जो आगे जाकर हुआ इट गिव्स यू कॉन्फिडेंस बेसिकली कि हम कुछ भी कर सकते हैं आईआईटी का थप्पा हमारे अंदर है I didn't make the best use of it after IIT, wo aage tak hua, but still. So I go to US in 2004, I end up there and I got to do, I joined the PhD program frankly in University of Washington, Seattle, Computer Science. One of the top 5-6 colleges, universities in the US for computer science, specifically in databases where I was interested. So amazing opportunity, I mean, next. Talk about something which happened there. So this is our campus, this is our institute building, okay. I mean, it doesn't look very great here, but it is amazing because it's at a lakefront. It is in Seattle, which is the headquarters of Microsoft. Now, wahan Amazon bhi hai, headquarters of Amazon bhi hai. Of course, all the big companies, it's like a huge, it's one of the best, I mean, computer science departments in the US. So I had all that great, I mean, I was like, yeah, लाइफ सेट हो गई यार मतलब अमेजिंग वर्क राइट वी गॉट टू गेट हियर बट समथिंग वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग हैपेंड मतलब लाइफ आई मीन दिस इज लाइक द टर्निंग पॉइंट एंड मेनी ऑफ माय फ्रेंड्स स्टिल थिंक व्हाट हैपेंड टू यू आफ्टर दैट सो माय टू रूममेट्स व्हेन आई वाज एट यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ वाशिंगटन वन ऑफ देम वाज फ्रॉम ट्रिपल आई टी हैदराबाद वन ऑफ देम वाज फ्रॉम अ वेरी स्मॉल कॉलेज इन महाराष्ट्र ठीक है जैसे अपना मेंटालिटी होता है कि हम आई टी में हम सब कुछ आता है वी आर द क्रीम ऑफ द नेशन एंड एवरीबॉडी इज राइटिंग आर्टिकल्स अबाउट अस घर पे जाते रिश्तेदार लोग आपके बारे में बड़े बड़े बातें करते हैं राइट वी आर ऑल थिंकिंग वी आर एट द आई मीन वी आर द बेस्ट वी आर द बेस्ट वी आर द बेस्ट मूवीज आर मेड ऑन अस आर्टिकल्स आर रिटन ऑन अस सो वी आर वेरी वेरी हैप्पी बट आई व्हेन आई मेट माय टू रूममेट्स मे बी इन टर्म्स ऑफ माय नॉलेज इन टेक्निकल नॉलेज दे वर नॉट एज गुड बट द नॉलेज अबाउट द कंट्री tremendous knowledge, मतलब there were like banks of knowledge, उनके पास the understanding they had about the country, जितना उन्होंने ground level से काम करके कुछ कुछ सीखा है, कितने उन्होंने उनके families ने मतलब उतने tough situations face किए, I felt I knew nothing, और personally I at that time I'm always a person who wants to read and understand, तो रात रात भर बात करते थे, and I just keep listening to these guys what they are supposed to say. So it was very, very shocking for me. I felt very small that and I'll tell you one thing, very interesting thing, which my friend Shreyas, who was from Maharashtra, told me. He said, you have done your education on my dad's money. Okay? That statement still hits me very hard. We are doing the best education in the country on taxpayers' money. Okay, subsidized education, right? It's not, it's very difficult to afford this kind of education. So he said, what are you doing here, dude? मतलब तू कर क्या रहा है यहाँ पर? My dad has logged all his life and has paid taxes for people like you. And you did this and you don't give a damn. फिर कुछ पता नहीं देश के बारे में, देश के problems के बारे में. और तू यहाँ क्या कर रहा है? I mean, why should I pay for you? And you get lost. Okay. So I was like, man, कुछ तो सच बोल रहा है. इसमें तो सच. I mean, you can have the arrogance and say I don't care. But somehow I felt that this guy is saying the truth. Very nice guy, I mean, we are still friends. So we started something called Hindu Students Council because in the US, when you are a minority, right, yahan par hum sab ek hai, but where we are very small, right, this huge American population, you want to understand about your own culture, your own things. So we formed a small group called the Hindu Students Council and we did a lot of reading about the country, the culture, the history, the issues. Lot of things, we organized lot of talks, lot of festivals, lot of campus events. So, tab tak mujhe pata nahi tha ki I have something called leadership, I have something called organization capability. Kyunki hamesha main apne computer ke samne baith ke I was doing just that. But jab main logon ke beech mein gaya, started talking to them, learned about them, to mujhe laga mere bahut sari capacity hai which I can use. So we started this group. It became amazingly popular on campus. It did amazing, great work. Then me personally, I traveled to many campuses in the country, in the US, and we started a lot of chapters of Hindu Students Council doing different things. And still many of them are still running, a lot of them still know me in the US. So, एक leadership capability मेरे में भी है, ये मुझे पता नहीं था. So, and when I started reading, I read a lot of things. One of the few defining books which I read, because me being a techie guy, I don't know how many of you have read Tao of Physics. I mean, okay. So, you have to be interested in quantum physics, that kind of thing. It's written by a person called Fritjof Capra. He's an Austrian quantum physicist. Okay. So, ye kitab somebody just suggested to me. Ya padho. Okay. So, this book relates the Eastern wisdom, matlab jo bhi Upanishads mein likha hai ya Bhagavad Gita mein likha hai isme, with quantum physics. Jo aaj jo discoveries ho rahi hai by the top tier institutes in the world in quantum physics, that knowledge base already exists in some form in the scriptures. ठीक है? ये अगर कोई बोलेगा तो कोई believe नहीं करेगा. Like I am not a person who believes such things. ठीक है? I don't believe. But it is a very popular book. A lot of people have read it. He himself is a very renowned physicist. तो वो पढ़ने से I will say कि मतलब it was mind blowing for me. It might not be mind blowing for all of you. It depends on your interest. But books have changed me to a large extent. And this book was amazing, amazing, amazing book. So shocking in many aspects. So that I read. Of course, Swami Vivekananda, through our reading groups, we came to know about it. We read a lot of things about him. Some of them are very philosophical, kuch samajh mein nahi aata hai. But one very practical book, why I put this thing here, which I want all of you to read. It's very easy to read. It's called Lectures from Kolhapur to Almora. This is after Swamiji gave his talk in the World Parliament of Religions and he came back to India. And he traveled from Kolhapur to Almora giving lectures all across the country. So each lecture is written down there. 2-3 pages each, you can easily finish it in 15-20 minutes. So, an amazing clarity about that person, what vision he had about India, the passion he talks, what he believes youth should do. So, I mean, again, the books which really changed me a lot. So, that one of them was that, and I would recommend all of you to take it. It's very, very easily available. I just saw a stall when I was coming here. Ramakrishna Mathura stall is outside. I'm definitely sure if there's a book stall there, that book will be there. Because it's the most popular book which Ramakrishna Mathura has ever sold ever. I mean, of all the books. So, this is definitely a must read for people. It's not about philosophy, it's totally about India, the youth, what we should be doing, right? And it's coming, of course, coming from a great person's mind, so it's very important for us to know. Other thing which I read, how many of you know about Savarkar? You've heard of Savarkar, of course, right? Not given the credit which is due. Very, very great literary genius, done amazing research on India, and one of the foremost freedom fighters. So, he wrote a book on Indian history. It's called The Six Glorious Epochs of Indian History. Indian history as we don't know it, right? We don't know India. I would say what we have read in our textbooks is not Indian history. We don't know much about India at all, actually. Why should we know? Who cares? That's different. But if you care to know what is India, if you care to know what is Indian history, you should definitely read this. I mean, he has taken these stories from different parts of the country, talking to people and documenting, not what the British has told us. So, he talks about six different times when India was in crisis and we fought back. Okay. Six glorious epochs of Indian history, as he calls it. So, came to know about India in a totally different perspective. So, this is what happened. Other thing happened was, of course, after I finished my masters, I was going through so many things in my head. So, one of the things I thought was, I got an offer from Amazon.com. Okay. Now, in Seattle, that's one of the best companies. And it's still one of the best companies if you want to work in databases, systems, if you understand computer science. So you can imagine getting the best possible offer, which I would want to have. But I didn't join Amazon immediately after I got the offer. So I did something very different, which I want each one of you here to think about. So I had a job offer in hand, which I'm sure a lot of you will have here also, when the placement season starts. I said, I don't want to join, give me a 2 months break. So thodi alag soch. I said, give me 2 months break, I want to do something different. And US companies are accommodative. They said, okay, theek hai, to do America break. They said, what do you want to do? I said, I want to go to a country which is not US, of course, not India, somewhere else. He said, okay, fine, you'll do what you want, but you come back 2 months later. Okay. So I talked to a lot of people. I knew some people there. So I went to a country called Suriname. How many of you heard of Suriname? Okay. It's not a very famous country. It has 5 lakh population. Everybody has heard of Brazil, right? It's above Brazil. It's in South America. Very small country, 5 lakh population. The most interesting, that the only big achievement probably Suriname has is one of their swimmers got a bronze medal in some Olympics sometime. That's all they know. Nothing else has happened great for that country. So nobody will know about it. But I went to that country because 1/3 of that country's population is Indian. I mean, how many of us can imagine? There's a country called Suriname in South America. 1/3 of its population is from India, and they are from this part of India. They are from UP and Bihar. So they went there in late 1800s. When people didn't know what is crossing the seas, right? Even Vivekananda had not gone to US. They went before that. Okay. So that's very, very interesting according to me. That, and we don't even know, we don't have any relations with them. So they were taken as slave laborers to work in the sugarcane farms of Suriname. Okay. So very interesting. I'll tell you some simple stats about that country. They still speak Bhojpuri. They speak a very unique combination of Bhojpuri, Awadhi, Hindi, English, Dutch combined. Okay. It's a Dutch speaking country. Okay. So if I'm talking here, I'm Hindi English mix. So can you imagine in 120 years, how much will mix in them? But they speak Bhojpuri. So when I land, I talk to some people. It's like this Hanuman Chalisa, jo dikha hai na, that kind of language. Okay. Yeah.
I'm from a district called Bali of Uttar Pradesh, and I'm a YAT student of here. And over there, my mother tongue has been Bhojpuri. But in 6th class, I have been a student of Bhojpuri school.
Oh, very good. Congrats. So, yeah, you will love that place. I'll tell you why you will love that place. Especially people from this land will love that place, because when they went those many years back, they had no contact with the country. Now, imagine I pick you up from here and throw you in some other part of the world. There is no way you can go back. There is no telephone, no internet, no TV, nothing at that time. Okay. So they preserved the culture exactly the way they saw it. Okay. So if you want to see how India was in 1800s, you should go there. Especially if our Bhojpuri friend there wants to see how their people were 120 years back. They have frozen the culture because they had no contact. Abhi abhi jaake sab TV, Bollywood se things are changing. But at that time they didn't have any of these things. What would these people, so these people were all 30 people in one boat, put in a boat, sent on a ship, sent on a boat for 30 day journey in the seas, oceans way. Okay. What are the things they would carry? I want you to think. What would they carry with them? Because slaves, slaves, so they don't give them much access, right? You can imagine, it's very bad. They'll put a lot of guys, few women, and they'll send them. Okay. They were not allowed to carry anything. But they carried only one thing. Can anybody guess that?
Ramayana.
They carried Ramcharitmanas. Amazing, right? I mean, the kind of faith they have on that, and we don't have. So they carried only that. Even to this day, agar aapne bola ki kuch dharm ka kaam karna hai, they will say, "Mere bete ko le jao." So take him, get him involved, do whatever. But why? हम जब भारत से आए थे, हम सिर्फ वो लेकर आए, हम उसके लिए काम नहीं करेंगे तो किसके लिए काम करेंगे? वी आर अ प्रोडक्ट ऑफ दैट, दैट इज आवर ओनली ट्रेजर. इफ यू आर वर्किंग टू प्रिजर्विंग दैट इन एंड वॉट एवर श्री राम हैज सेड, इट्स ग्रेट, वी वुड वांट टू सपोर्ट यू. सो दैट लेवल ऑफ श्रद्धा, आई विल टेक क्वेश्चंस लेटर. ओके. सो दैट लेवल ऑफ श्रद्धा दे हैव ऑन दैट, एंड इट वाज वेरी अमेजिंग फॉर मी टू सी वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग थिंग्स. दे डोंट हैव सरनेम्स, दे हैव सरनेम्स फ्रॉम देयर एंसेस्टर्स, नॉट एज द कास्ट स्पेसिफिक सरनेम्स वी हैव नाउ. They put some flags outside their homes after they do puja. If you do Hanuman puja, you put a saffron flag. If you do a Devi puja, you put a black flag. So everybody knows how many pujas that they have done. Very interesting stories. I mean, fascinating stuff. And they all speak Dutch in the university there. There was just one university that didn't have a computer science department. Okay. So I was supposed to go and tell them to start a computer science department. Okay. So I took some sessions for the faculty. I took some sessions for students. To build this enthusiasm towards computers in that university there. Whole country is only one university. And that doesn't have a computer science department. So I tried doing that, it was not a success. But I enjoyed it. So I came back. Then my thoughts, I joined Amazon. Matlab, Amazon was very amazing company, very demanding. Amazon is the world's biggest online retailer, right? So they do the maximum business. So I was in the databases side. Usme kya hota hai ki the database goes down, the website goes down. If website goes down, every period the company loses $1 million. Okay? So my job is to ensure the database never goes down. It is very stressful because they might wake me up in the middle of the night and call me, "Thik karo, thik karo." Very, very challenging job. But I enjoyed it a lot. But what I realized finally is I am not a person who can sit behind a desk and work. कोई और मुझे ideas दे रहा है और मैं उसके ideas पे काम कर रहा हूँ. वो company के CEO का जो vision है, उसका vision है कि भाई मुझे इतने जूते बेचने इस quarter में. और पूरी company जोड़ तोड़ लगा के वो बेचेगी. क्योंकि that is the business ना, business तो वही है. It is not my dream, it is not my vision. ये जो चाहता है हमें सब पता है, सब कुत्तों के साथ काम करते हैं, right? This is not my thing. Lot of people enjoy, पर वो मुझे नहीं जमता है. And sitting behind this computer for 12 hours in a day doing something. And whatever I did during my college days at Hindu Students Council, वो यहाँ पर नहीं हो रहा है. I'm not enjoying it. So I decided I'll come back to India. Now I had almost spent 5 years in US. This is a very, very difficult decision because after 5 years in US, you are eligible for something called a green card. Okay. And you are hitting a manageable age. And आपके लिए घर पे रिश्ते ढूंढते हैं. वो पूछने का है, बच्चा यूएस में है, ठीक है, ऑल दिस थिंग्स हैपन. तो आई एम थिंकिंग नाउ कि वापस जाना चाहिए क्या, वापस जाके क्या करना चाहिए. तो आई एम जस्ट थिंकिंग एंड आई एम डूइंग सम रीडिंग. सो व्हेन आई डू अ लॉट ऑफ रीडिंग, आई केम अक्रॉस दिस बुक, पीपल मस्ट हैव हर्ड ऑफ मोहम्मद यूनुस. ही वाज अ स्टार एट दैट टाइम बिकॉज 2005 नोबेल पीस प्राइज ही वन फॉर समथिंग कॉल्ड माइक्रो क्रेडिट माइक्रो फाइनेंस ग्रामीण बैंक, ओके, इन बांग्लादेश. सो I read all his books and I really, really loved what he said. I mean, he's saying how you can do well for others and still do well for yourself. Okay? So it's a social business. How you give loans, micro loans, to people who cannot have access to loans. So I read that book, Banker to the Poor. It totally changed my thinking. So I thought social entrepreneurship is the way to go. Matlab, I'll go back to India. I can't start Grameen Bank, but I'll do something on those lines. So, social enterprise, social entrepreneurship was very, very popular after Grameen Bank won the Nobel Peace Prize. So, I got highly inspired. So, I'm sitting at home one day and I just write my resignation letter to my manager. घर से बैठे-बैठे laptop पे लिख दिया मैंने, ठीक है, कि भाई I'm going back. You want 2 weeks notice? I'll give you 2 weeks notice. So this is a very shocking decision. Matlab, decisions to come back to India are not made so easily. But this is an emotional decision. You cannot, isme logic ke khilaf, everything is against the logic. Because you are working for the best company. You are in a very good position. Everything is going for you, right? Abhi kya hai yaar, what else do you want in life? Jo hamare ghar mein settle jo kuch hai na, settle. To settle ko check mark ho gaya. He settled now. So everything is settled now. What's the problem? Why are you unsettling yourself again? But I thought I should unsettle myself because from within I was unsettled. Everybody else must have thought is settled. But I am not feeling comfortable. So I just quit and in 2 days time I fly back to India. Okay. And according to me, that was the greatest decision I took in my life. It was difficult, but difficult decisions are taken impulsively, right? बहुत ही टफ लास्ट ओवर में 5 रन मार रहे हैं तो धोनी जोगिंदर सिंह को देगा बॉल. Who would have thought of that? Nobody would have thought of that, right? You have to take it. You have to take a decision. You have to take it at the spur of the moment. Took it. I didn't argue too much कि क्या करना चाहिए क्या नहीं करना चाहिए. I just came back. Greatest thing, parents are very happy. ठीक है, क्योंकि दो लड़के हैं, एक तो बाहर, दोनों बाहर थे, तो एक तो आ गया वापस, अच्छा खुश, राइट, हमें हमारी देखभाल करने के लिए कोई आ गया, राइट, they're very happy. I'll tell you the, maybe I'll talk about it later, but one of the most liberating moments of my life. Because you have quit the US, you have quit your job, you are coming back to India not knowing what you will do. So it should be a very confusing position, right? You should be confused, kya karna hai. But when you are not doing anything and you have the whole blackboard empty, the canvas is blank, you can paint whatever you want. The ultimate freedom ka experience. So I came back, I'll just go next and say. So I came back in 2009, September end, okay. So one of the first places I visited, I mean, ab kya karna hai mujhe koi idea nahi hai. So a lot of people where I was discussing in the afternoon, students are confused what to do in life, what to do next, insecurity ki feeling hai. So what I did what Vivekananda did, travel the country. Okay, if you want to know what you are, what you want to do, you have to travel. Travel. So I traveled. So I just traveled a lot of places. I just put one pick actually. This pick, I don't know if you can see, it says Lower Dibang Valley, Arunachal Pradesh, India. Okay. Now this place is at the border of Arunachal and China. From there you get to China border. So there's a person there. His name is Vijay Swami. Nobody will know of him, but if you search on the net, you'll find it. Definitely you should search for the thing Rewatch. Okay. So you'll know what is Rewatch. So this guy is starting a university in Arunachal Pradesh, in the middle of the tribal area, on China border. ठीक है देखो बहुत ही फैसिनेटिंग लगा हुआ आइडिया व्हाट इज डूइंग रिसर्च एरिया टोटली डिफरेंट है ही वांट्स टू रिसर्च द ट्राइब्स ठीक है तो दिस गाय गिव्स मी एन ऑफर कि आप आकर यहां पर हम दोनों साथ में यूनिवर्सिटी खड़ा करते हैं इट्स वेरी चैलेंजिंग आई लव इट ठीक है अरुणाचल इज अ वेरी वेरी डिफिकल्ट प्लेस देयर इज नो गुड रोड्स एक्सेस देयर इज नो डेवलपमेंट पानी दिल्ली तो मे बी यूपी से भी बदतर है राइट सो इट इज वेरी वेरी बैड आई मीन बट इट्स वेरी वेरी ब्यूटीफुल इट्स अ न्यू चैलेंजिंग प्रोजेक्ट The project which will have generations of impact, agar karenge to. So he gives me that offer, I just say, okay, think about it. I traveled to a lot of things, I did a lot of things. I stayed in very difficult places and all that. Finally, what I understood is, by meeting lot of youth, lot of them want to do something. Hame kuch karna hai, hame kuch karna hai, hame kuch karna hai. Hame ye nahi pata ki hame kya karna hai. Hame ye nahi pata ki kaise karna hai. Hamare paas samay kam hai. So all these things people told me. और दूसरी तरफ पीपल हु आर डूइंग सोशल वर्क दे आर ऑल सेइंग वी नीड यूथ वी नीड योर आइडियाज वी नीड मोर एंड मोर आइडियाज वी नीड मोर एंड मोर टेक्नोलॉजी वी वांट टू डू मोर तो विद सो मेनी पीपल आर विलिंग टू ऑफर देयर हेल्प एंड सो मेनी पीपल आर वांटिंग देयर हेल्प व्हाई इज इट नॉट हैपनिंग द सिंपल थिंग इज देयर इज नो वे टू ब्रिज दिस ठीक है आप लोग जस्ट इन दिस क्लासरूम देयर इज सो मच ऑफ टैलेंट सो मच ऑफ नॉलेज वॉट यू हैव इन ईच वन ऑफ यू lot of people outside need it they don't know how to reach you don't know how to reach them that's the problem that's all to in dono ko bridge kar sakte hai kya so that was the idea and then with that we started something called youth for seva so youth for seva is a platform youth for seva is trying to connect people who want to do health to people who need the help in very very simple activities jo bhi kar sakte so I'll not talk about much but It has started in Bangalore first, then in Hyderabad I started, then it went to Chennai, it went to Delhi, it went to Mumbai. Now, this year we are planning to start in 15 more cities. Hopefully, Kanpur will be one of them. So, we want to start. There's so much of interest. My impression of Indian youth was, ye sab type pass hai, koi kuch nahi karega, sab matlab movie dekhte hai, pub jaate hai, koi youth ko kisi ko samaj ke prati interest nahi hai. That was my feeling. But when I went and talked to people, very very different situation which you can see today also how things are changing so we formed a group it became very big we are involving thousands and thousands of volunteers across the country doing different things I put this very interesting picture here because anyway can people say where the picture is from huh if you are confident shout why are you shy sorry tell me loudly hyderabad doesn't have hills like that at the back हाँ कोई भी गेस मारो यार दिस नो रॉन्ग आंसर इट्स नॉट अरुणाचल इट इज नॉट उत्तराखंड इट इज कश्मीर यू कैन से तोलोलिंग किसने सुना है तोलोलिंग टाइगर हिल ओके दिस इज द्रास ओके द्रास सेक्टर लक्ष्मी दे से दिस गाइस क्लाइंबिंग अप टाइगर हिल जीतना है ऑल दोस थिंग्स So, I'm just giving you the way the whole life turned around for me. So, what we did, of the so many things Youth for Seva did all across the country, one of the things we did is 26 July is called Kargil Vijay Divas. Okay, this was the 13th anniversary of Kargil Vijay Divas, 26 July. So, what we did, 12 of us, of course the whole group was involved, I think it was 4,363 days since we won the Kargil War. We do 4,366 signatures or messages from people across the country on a 100 meter sheet. We had a huge sheet and we took signatures of all these people for wishing our jawans on the borders. Okay, and we carried this 100 meter sheet all the way to Kargil. Okay, this is in Dras. Dras has a war memorial, okay, where every year they do some ceremony. Okay, but to this day, till we went, no civilian group has ever gone to Dras in the Dras ceremony. Okay, so we have no contact. Matlab, can you imagine the power of youth? Nahi pata. तो वो बहुत मनाने के बाद वो बोलते हैं ठीक है 10 मिनट आप देख करा सकते हैं अंदर. सो वी गो इन एंड वी टॉक टू फ्यू ऑफ द पीपल गॉट बाला सिंह बट वन मोर परमवीर चक्र द ओनली अदर वन आई लाइक योगेंद्र सिंह यादव वाज देयर. इफ यू हैव सीन द मूवी इफ यू आर फैसिनेटेड बाय इट एलओसी कारगिल इफ यू हैव सीन अमेजिंग अमेजिंग थिंग वी कैन सी टाइगर हिल राइट इन फ्रंट ऑफ अस एंड ग्रेट थिंग. सो देन द जवान से और द पीपल हु आर देयर दे से यू स्टे विद अस आई मीन यू आर नॉट गोइंग बैक. This has never happened before. So they make us stay there. We attend the ceremony. The 100 meter sheet which we carried from the rest of the country is still in the Dras War Memorial. It is the only civilian thing which is there. You can go, you can scroll it and you can read all the messages from across the country. That is the highest honor we got. So it is there on the Dras War Memorial today. And they host us in their camps. They cook food for us. They do a lot of party, dance, all those things with them. So they are so impressed. And we are so happy that we could do this. What I am saying is in the 1999 Kargil war where I didn't care a damn about who I was and what this whole thing is happening. About 12 years later I am in Dras now in the same place the war happened and I am like crying with tears meeting all these people. So a lot of transformation happened and the whole team is super excited. We do a lot of great things and we come back. Then we do other things, we do a lot of trips like this. Maybe you can go next year or something like this. So this is from Uttarakhand, people were guessing. So this is from Uttarakhand, we are there about 2 months, 3 months back. Team of 25 volunteers from across the country. We did a 12-day tour, we did a lot of relief work in Uttarakhand. I mean very, very challenging. We are very fortunate we didn't lose anybody, it was that bad. Like you can see landslides like this, rocks falling, people trying to cross. This guy has a video camera in his hand. So we did a lot of fascinating work like this. And then we did a lot of small things, like we distribute school bags to children. We do teaching in government schools, we clean our own streets. So, we have designed a variety of activities in Youth for Seva. For somebody you can give 2 hours a week, to somebody you can give maybe 20 hours a week. For all types of people, different types of activity, lot of interesting, passionate, adventurous, whatever youth loves, right? We have designed activities and the response has been tremendous all across the country. So, whoever thought Seva is boring, not interesting, is not like that. It is a lot of fun, lot of enjoyment. But the one thing I have seen maybe thousands of volunteers come out and do things. Not a single person has said, "Arey, bore ho gaya yaar." You might go watch a movie, come back and say, "Bore ho gaya, paisa waste ho gaya." You might go to a big restaurant, eat some food, come back and say, "Arey, bekar, mirch kam thi, namak zyada tha," whatever. But nobody who has done volunteer work across the world, I have seen, has come back and said, "Bore ho gaya." So what is the problem? If the activity is so exciting, so much fun, so much learning and enjoyment, so why are we not doing it? So more and more people are joining us, they are doing things and we are spreading the Youth for Seva across. So yeah, I will not talk about detail about Youth for Seva. Currently we are in five cities and lot of colleges, lot of young professionals, lot of corporates, multinationals, lot of them are coming out and volunteering. Doing different things. We are into education, health, environment, disability, lot of different activities. People who are interested, I can talk in more detail. Of course, you can check out the website youthforseva.org. We'll go next. This is some media coverage. This is all fine. I mean, when you do good work and youth is involved, of course, you get a lot of coverage. So this is some of it. We'll go next. Right. So one more thing. Very important. See, if you understand the mindset when I am coming back from the US and doing things, suppose I come back, just imagine my plight. I am from a middle class family. I did pre-tech computer science, I worked for Amazon, I came back. Then, when I am in Hyderabad, I don't know after I come back what I will do. So, if I go to any party, Rishtar lo kya pushte, beta kya karte ho? What should I say? I don't have an answer. ढूंढ रहा हूँ क्या करना है सोच रहा हूँ राइट घूम रहा हूँ बट व्हाट आई एम डूइंग एक्चुअली राइट बट दे डोंट अंडरस्टैंड यू आर अ फेलियर राइट यू आर अ फेलियर बिकॉज आपका पूरा एजुकेशन, आपका पूरा जो एक्सपीरियंस है लाइफ का, आपने बस ऐसी व्यर्थ उड़ा दिया, आप क्या कर रहे हैं, राइट? दे लुक एट यू लाइक अ लूजर, बट यू नो यू आर नॉट अ लूजर बिकॉज यू आर चूजिंग टू डू दिस. सो एंड थ्रू आउट द जर्नी ऑफ यूथ फॉर सेवा, स्पेशली फॉर द फास्ट 3-4 इयर्स आई हैव बीन विद इट, अ लॉट ऑफ बैलेंस इज नीडेड टू हैव क्लैरिटी इन योर माइंड अबाउट व्हाई यू आर डूइंग दिस. वंस यू नो व्हाई यू आर डूइंग इट, हाउ टू डू इट, व्हाट टू डू इज ऑल वेरी क्लियर. So one of the greatest things again which happened to me was I read this book called Mystic Musings. It's a must read if anybody of you is interested into spirituality. Even if you are not into anything, it is a very very amazing book. So I used to have a lot of free time, kuch kaam nahi tha. So I used to just go into these bookstores, jo crossword, the landmark wagera rehta hai na, wahan pe they allow you to go and read books. So I'll just take a book and sit and read it. So I just picked up this book by mistake, maybe, I don't know. I just picked up this book and was reading and I was very very fascinated by what this person, Jaggis, Vasudev, Sadhguru Vasudev, he had to say about spirituality and yoga. So I took up a lot of yoga, I still practice a lot of yoga and that has given me a lot of balance in life. It has given me clarity about what I am doing. I mean, without that I would not be here because there is so much of confusion when you are taking difficult decisions like this. I still practice a lot of yoga, so yes, and techniques to do that. So. But anyway, it's a must read. Even if you don't want to practice yoga, it's a must read if you want to have any inclination towards something beyond material. Right. So when they invited me here, they asked me to talk about social entrepreneurship. And I've not yet talked about social entrepreneurship. So social entrepreneurship, I've given a lot of talks, but what I felt about social entrepreneurship is it's only a fancy idea. I have not seen a single IITian coming out and getting involved in social entrepreneurship. So I think it is, I mean, it is very different. What I will say is, so again going back and when I do reading, what Sadhguru has got to say is, whether you manufacture a safety pin, a computer or a spaceship or you teach people to meditate, there is only one business in the world, the business of human well-being. Whatever business you do, whatever you do in life, I was talking to my friends here about research. What pissed me off big time about research in US was, it's all to publish papers. Very little about it is about people, they don't care. It's about how many papers you can publish, how many, I mean, you can get the star marks on yourself, get grants from the US government, do more publishing. The relevance to society is very minimal in academia in the US and growingly in India also. So, whatever you do in life, if you just keep this in mind that I'm doing this for the welfare of the people, you might earn for yourself, there's no problem about that. He's saying whether you manufacture a safety pin or you manufacture a spaceship, whatever you do, just think that you're doing it for human welfare. With that mindset, you do it. If you're doing research, if whatever you're doing a project, PTP project, if you think I'm doing it for the welfare of others, it's a totally different way of doing things. So, after that, I don't talk about social entrepreneurship because even if I open a restaurant, if I do it well, and if I do it thinking that the person who's eating the food is like my brother or sister, then I will do it well. I might earn money out of it. But for everything you do, if you think you are doing it for society in some larger context, then you will do it well. So, businesses cannot be classified anymore. Are they social or not social? They have to be social. I mean, that should be the mindset of every big business leader out there. That's what he's got to say. So he says, as long as business leaders remain aware of this fact, and that human well-being is the only purpose of doing business, business is fine. Don't be thinking that business is bad. Just do business, 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 but always think of the people when you're doing business. So, next. So this April, I'll be joining ISB. You must have heard of ISB, Indian School of Business. So that is like a top business school in the country. It's among the top 20 in the world. So why I'm doing this is again the same reason. I think, we have to understand that there's nothing wrong in earning money. Okay. Doing seva matlab are shobhit kya hai yaar ye kaise ho sakta hai to sab kuch chhod chhod ke. Nothing wrong about earning money and all those things. It's about how you can do good to the maximum number of people. So I realize I'm doing something with Youth for Seva, which is good, but I want to do a lot more and reach out to a lot many more people. So for that I have to go back to school again, and which is maybe after 8 years I'll be going back and sitting in a classroom. And I'll be learning about how to do business, and I might do business or I might not do it, but I want to understand how things are done. So I thought it's a good way to go back and learn again. So I thought I have the technical knowledge, all those things. I need more of the business education. So I'll be going back to ISB in in April of this year. It's a 1 year course. I want to come back and do much more. So that's the goal of going there. Right, so I don't know all this big story, it sounds like a fairy tale. But some things I have learned, which I think, they might not be right, I mean, this is my learning. But just thinking about it, I wrote some things down. Yeah, so this is the first most important thing which I believe. You have to go beyond competition. This is, I learned it the very, very hard way. What happened was, when you have to get through JEE, especially in the kind of coaching centers we all go through, and from childhood, I've been groomed. You have to talk, padhai likhai karo, you have to beat others. So, you're sitting in this coaching center, you know, among these three people in the row, one of you will make it. So, hopefully, it is you. So, you're always in that competitive feeling. You get that. And always in life, after getting to IIT, also, it's very competitive, relative grading. Everybody knows this big story. So, it's always about beating the guy next to you. The company comes for placement, they will take away 10, 20 people. You have to be one of them. If you apply to grad school, there will be 4 or 5 people who get in from the college, so you have to be one of them. So competition, till the day I resigned from Amazon, I was always in competition. The moment I realized we should not be in the competition, that's when I did best in life. I mean, koi lagna aapki chal raha hai, aap usse tez chalne ki koshish kar rahe, it's just as simple as that. I mean, maybe you can fly, you don't know. Maybe you can fly, but how will you ever know you will fly? You always try to beat the guy beside you. So you have to quit. Quit the race and think about it yourself. So that was a very, very key decision and perhaps the happiest day of my life, because all IT employees out there, they carry these laptops, bags on their neck, go to office, come back. The day I walked out of Amazon without a laptop bag on me and a badge, right? Not knowing what I will do tomorrow, but having the ultimate freedom to do whatever I want. Very, very happy. I mean, I still remember those days and it gives me a lot of confidence. So that was the first thing I would want all of you to think. I mean, you might not be thinking as competitively as me, but think beyond competition. Don't think of beating the guy next to you. There's no point. There's no success there. You'll always try to beat this guy, then that guy, then that guy. You will never get anywhere. So you have to think beyond competition, think freely. Okay? Yeah. Right. The other thing I felt, the reason why I'm here, you're inviting me, which I don't have any great credentials to be here, but I'm still here, is if you think what beyond me, इसमें मुझे क्या मिलेगा हर चीज में इसमें मुझे क्या मिलेगा. But you take any great person in life, anybody across the world, across time, the only people who became great and society accepts them as great is the people who thought beyond themselves. ठीक है, even if you hear Tendulkar's final speech, ठीक है, he's not saying I've played for the records, I've played for the country. ठीक है, you take a sports person, you take a scientist, you take anybody in the world, a businessman, people who have thought beyond themselves have done amazingly well. Steve Jobs, whatever great innovations, he didn't think about, will my company earn the profit? How do I make technology cute, friendly to everybody? So that's how he thought about it. So that's how he became great. So you have to think beyond yourself. But when we are here in this institute, we always think about myself. Mujhe kya milega, mujhe kya milega, mujhe kya milega. So you will be a loser, and if you are aspiring for greatness, you have to think beyond yourself. This is one more lesson I have learned. Yeah. Other things, explore. I mean, if you think about it, till the age of maybe 30, 32, you have freedom, actually. Our society, that way, like once you get into a family structure, you have a lot of commitments, your parents get older, we are in a family system, lot of responsibilities come upon you. So we are dealing with very short span of time, maybe 22 to 32 is the 10 years of age we have, where we can do a lot of things. But we don't make the best use of this time at all. Matlab, we just do something else. Matlab, 32 saal ke baad or 35 saal ke baad becomes very, very difficult. Even though, first of all, it's difficult to change your mind. Even if your mind changes, the circumstance might not allow you to take a decision. Jitna experiment karna hai, abhi kar lo. It's the best time and nothing is lost. Nothing is lost, I'll tell you. Everybody in the world who has done something different has learned something. Nobody has ever said it's a failure. Ki maine galat kadam liya. So they have always come back with a lot of happiness about what they have done. If you ask me, Shobhi, toh aapne kuch galti kiya kya? I would not say. Every moment was a very difficult decision, but I enjoyed after the decision. So we should make risk-taking capacity, अभी है समय यू टेक अ ब्रेक फॉर अ ईयर, कुछ भी नहीं जाएगा लाइफ में, कुछ भी नहीं जाएगा, पर वो ब्रेक नहीं लेंगे तो बहुत कुछ जाएगा, ये मैं बोलता हूँ. टेक अ ब्रेक आफ्टर यू फिनिश योर बीटेक और व्हाटएवर यू टेक योर डिग्री, टेक अ ब्रेक फॉर अ ईयर, डू समथिंग डिफरेंट एंड कम बैक. नौकरी मिल जाएगी, ये भी मिल जाएगी, सब हो जाएगा, कोई बड़ा प्रॉब्लम नहीं है. आई मीन वो एक साल अगर आपने ब्रेक नहीं लिया, या फिर दो महीने ब्रेक नहीं लिया आपने, या तीन महीने ब्रेक नहीं लिया आपने, फिर आपको कभी ब्रेक लेने का मौका नहीं मिलेगा. एवरी डे बिकम्स मोर डिफिकल्ट, सो यू हैव टू टेक अ ब्रेक व्हेनेवर यू वांट. सो आई एम गोइंग बैक टू स्टडीज नाउ, उसके बाद क्या करूंगा आई डोंट नो, बट आई डिड यूथ फॉर सेवा फॉर 4 years, बहुत कुछ सीखने को मिला. दैट ब्रेक इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड एक्सप्लोर इन दैट ब्रेक, सो यू गेट क्लियर ऑफ क्लैरिटी एज आई बिलीव. इन द रिफ्लेक्शन दिस इज समथिंग आई फील यूथ टुडे इज नॉट डूइंग. मतलब इतना फास्ट लाइफ हो गया है, इतना इन्फॉर्मेशन ओवरडोज हो गया है, एवरीथिंग इज एक्सेसिबल, यू जस्ट सर्च एंड यू फाइंड इट. कोई भी रुक के ब्रेक मार के सोच नहीं रहा है कि व्हाट शुड आई बी डूइंग. आई मीन एवरीबॉडी गोज, आई मीन इट्स नॉट टू टेक एन एग्जांपल फ्रॉम अ मूवी, बट व्हाई आई एम टेकिंग द 3 idiots एग्जांपल, इट्स बेस्ड ऑन आईआईटियंस, इट्स काइंड ऑफ बेस्ड ऑन रियलिटी, इफ नॉट एग्जैक्टली ऑन रियलिटी. Everybody watches the movie. Everybody comes back, claps and says it's great. Not a single one follows it. Okay. Everybody agrees with the concept also. ये सही है. हमें कुछ करना चाहिए तो हमारा inner calling है. क्योंकि हमने कभी समय दिया ही नहीं है कि रुक के सोचना है कि क्या करना है. वो रेस में ही लगे हैं. रेस के बाहर स्टेप आउट करके 10 minutes, 10 days, कुछ नहीं करके सोचेंगे कि क्या करना है. There is no introspection. There is no thinking. It's all about peer pressure. ये क्या कर रहा है, वो क्या कर रहा है, या फिर पेरेंट्स क्या बोल रहे हैं, या फिर टीचर क्या बोल रही है. बस खुद के कोई विचार नहीं है क्या करना चाहिए. सो यू हैव टू टेक अ ब्रेक एंड दैट्स व्हेन यू विल फाइंड व्हाट यू वांट टू डू. सो दैट इज व्हाट, एंड क्रिएटिविटी आता है उससे, यू डू थिंग्स वेरी डिफरेंटली. वरना जो नेट पे पढ़ा वो कर दिया, कॉपी पेस्ट हो गया, असाइनमेंट खत्म हो गया, चलते रहता है. इट्स ऑल ओके, इट्स ऑल फाइन, आई डिड दैट एज वेल, नथिंग अप विद दैट, बट इट नेवर गेट्स यू एनीवेयर इन द लॉन्ग रन. You want to do something just to get a grades, or you want to do something longer in life which you learn. That's the end of the presentation. This is my email ID and my phone number. What I want each one of you to do, I mean, I'll ask, of course, I think we have time for questions, right? So we'll take few questions for maybe about 15 minutes. Some of you might feel hesitant to ask some questions. Some of you would want to talk to me in great detail. You can always call me. You can always write to me on email. I'm on Facebook, I'm not on LinkedIn and all that, but I'm at least on Facebook. But it would be good if you write me an email. I'm more active on email than Facebook. So it would be good if you. But I would want you to ask me questions, what you think in your mind. Feel free, okay? Well, if you see, I was like you when I was 10 years back. So I totally understand the mindset, what you guys are thinking. So I would want to, why do I come, why should I come so far, talk to you people, right? Because I want to connect to you, talk back. If something like this had happened when I was at IIT Bombay, maybe it happened also actually. Maybe I was one of those people who's not here. Okay, give a damn about such things at that time. So I never had the opportunity. There was just one talk by one professor called Milind Soni. Very good prof at that time. He just didn't take a session that day, he didn't take a lecture, but he told us something about herd mentality. He said herd mentality. Now it's very popular. What herd mentality is? सामने वाली भैंस जा रही है, सब लोग वहीं जाते हैं. So, but at that time क्या तो फाट मार रहा है यार, क्या है, कुछ मजा नहीं आया. That is a kind of thinking. अरे कुछ तो लेक्चर मार दिया. But that thing still stuck to my mind. I mean, just a small intervention at this age, if somebody gives us a direction, in the long run it can change lives. So, I think you're all fortunate. I don't know if I was of any use to you people, but still, it might just trigger a thought somewhere. कि ऐसा भी कुछ हो सकता है. So I'd want you guys to ask me questions, and so that hopefully I can answer to the best of my capacity.
Sir, I'm Prashant, for the student. I had a question. Don't you think that if the society didn't force us into this competitive environment, we would have done better on all the fronts that you talked about, like all the mistakes that we did. So okay. We would have introspected more, and we would have thought about community service.
Oh, okay. It's see the question. If people get it, society ne hume force kiya hai to think competitively. आई थिंक शुड गेट आउट ऑफ माइंड सेट. ऐसा नहीं है, मतलब जब सोसाइटी में ऑफकोर्स वेन रिसोर्स क्रंच इज देयर, राइट, वेन सीट्स आर लेस इन आईआईटी, ऑफकोर्स जॉब्स आर लेस, सो देयर विल बी कॉम्पिटिशन. कॉम्पिटिशन कैनॉट बी अवॉइडेड, इट इज अप टू अस. रेस में आपको किसी ने कुछ नहीं किया, आपने कुछ ज्वाइन किया है. लेट अस एक्सेप्ट दैट फैक्ट. आफ्टर यूर एज्यूमिंग यू आर इन द रेस, नाउ आपने रेस में कूद गए, अभी रेस के बाहर जाना भी आपका ऑप्शन है. यू कैन स्टेप आउट ऑफ द रेस इफ यू वांट एनी टाइम. सोसाइटी विल नॉट स्टॉप यू, यू डू इट, यू डू इट. देयर विल बी सर्कमस्टेंसेस, यू हैव टू फेस देम, बट इफ द ऑप्शन इज ऑलवेज ओपन वेदर यू विल स्टेप आउट ऑफ द रेस. कैन वी डू दैट? डू वी हैव द करेज टू डू इट? डू वी हैव द क्लैरिटी इन लाइफ टू डू इट? दैट इज द क्वेश्चन. So, I think you should think about it. Let us not push the blame on society. Society के वजह से मैं हम आज इधर हैं, कोई सेवा के बारे में नहीं सोचता, ऐसा नहीं है. हम हमारी भी choice है उसमें. अगर हम वो choice ना लें, it's our choice. That's why Matrix is my favorite movie. It's always my choice. What is your choice? You can take a choice now. Take the blue pill or the red pill, right? The famous scene. You can take the blue pill anytime. ऐसा कुछ नहीं है. So, it is about your choice. So I would think, I mean, for that you need courage, you need clarity. For clarity you need to do a lot of introspection, a lot of reading. Oh, you can work on it and you can build that courage to do it. Let us not push the blame on somebody else.
Take after
back. Ah, yeah. Hindi mein sawal puch sakte hain, matlab I'm sorry ki main English mein baat kar raha hu, par I would also want to talk in Hindi. We'll take the next question.
Sir, I have 2-3 questions. First of all, how can I join this organization? What is the direct process? Then, what are the cities in which it is working right now? Because you said that it is not working in Kanpur. So, in which city I can go and work? And what are the activities that I get to do? Like that.
So, simple thing, I think first you should just go to the website, youthforsewa.org, register yourself, write me an email. There's nothing in Kanpur yet, but we know other organizations in Kanpur doing good work. So I can put you in touch. If you are willing, you can also start a Kanpur chapter. We'll tell you how to start something in Kanpur. Or wherever your hometown is, right? We also have a process to start new chapters. So we can tell you from wherever you are. It's an open invitation to all of you. If you want to start something like this, you want to involve youth, that is college students, young professionals, into volunteering work, seva work, in your respective cities or places you are studying, you can write to me and tell me how to do it. That is the next thing. Activities are based on need. You have to understand what is the need. A need in Kanpur might be different from a need in Hyderabad. Okay. So we first figure out what are the needs. What are the things we can fulfill? We can't solve all the big problems. What are small problems we can solve? And that's how we design the activities. So activities are very simple, which can be done in 2-3 hours. And they are not very, require a lot of skill, a lot of training. Simple teaching in schools, doing some sapling plantations, health activities, some small things. If we do, a lot of change happens if we do it together. Those are the activities. Right? Website has all the information on that. Okay,
we'll take. So after 4 years of regular social service, you chose to join ISB. Sir, what was the motivation behind this decision? Because if not you, one might digress into some other pursuits other than social service. Definitely. And have you introspected in this regard, as after ISB education, what have you thought?
Okay, so why to do ISB? That's also a choice. Of course, I've thought about why I want to do ISB. See, what I felt when I started doing Youth for Seva work is the response is very great. It's tremendous. Lot of people come to you. Lot of course, funds get raised. Lot of things happen. And without having the right managerial skills, you can't manage things. Either you are an inbuilt great manager by your own nature, but that will only take you to some level. What I have realized myself, that I can come to some level. But if I want Youth for Seva to run in 50 cities in the country, I would want to do some learning. So for that, lot of different things are there. One of them is a good business school education. How? Because you see, I find small companies, how they do amazingly well, how they scale, right? So, they teach you techniques on how and better managerial skills, okay. It will give you a clarity of thinking. Currently, I am just doing my gut feel. I think I want to say this. It will give you a structure to my thought. So, I thought that kind of education is very important for me. So, that's the reason I am doing this, not to go and do some other business later on, most likely. to come back to the sector, maybe youth for sale, maybe something else, and do something bigger. So in education will take you from year to year, right? What's the difference between a 10th pass student and you? You can do much more than that because you have an education in between. So getting the right education was what I felt at this time is most needed for me. So that's why I'm planning to go there and do something. And I want to come back to the sector and do things in a bigger way. So that's the reason. I saw one more hand there.
You had raised your hand?
Sure. Okay. You can take one more question.
So what has been your long-term motivation? Why you went to Coursera or why you couldn't have
See, there is no motivation. I mean, see, people live life in two different ways. One is through compulsion. Okay, ये करना पड़ रहा है इसलिए कर रहे हैं. ठीक है. I am not that kind of person. I mean, living by choice. So even when I was at IIT, we did many things which others would not do. So living by choice, that is a different level of freedom. You understand? See, if I have, I know a lot of my colleagues, in fact, ISB also will be, अरे ये जॉब ये डिग्री के बाद हमारी सैलरी 2x होगी 10x होगी 5x होगी राइट और वील गेट दिस ऑफर दैट ऑफर आई एम नॉट डूइंग इट लाइक दैट ठीक है सो एवरी डिसीजन आई हैव टेकन स्पेशली पोस्ट 2009 हैज बीन थ्रू माई चॉइस आई हैव अदर ऑप्शंस बट थिंकिंग अबाउट इट वॉट आई वॉन्ट टू डू वाई आई वॉन्ट टू देन टेकिंग दैट डिसीजन सो दैट हेल्प्स मी डू बेटर सो Yeah, I mean, I love living like that. So living through my own choice, that is my motivation. And I said little bit of spiritual backing, little bit of blessings of a lot of good people have helped me give that clarity. I mean, varna kya hota hai, this sector mein a lot of people come, bhatak bhi jate hai, kahi baar demoralized ho jate hai, a lot of things happen. I mean, there are so many failures at every step. This is not a 9-to-5 job, right? Where I get a paycheck at the end of the month. There are different things here. So, constant every day is a new adventure. So with that thing, it is difficult, but you need to be stay focused, you need to have clarity. For that, you need some kind of backing. If you wake up in the morning, the worst thing for me is not knowing what to do. Okay? If the day I wake up and I realize youth for sale is not what I want to do, I leave it. Okay? But when you wake up, you should have a direction, kuch purpose, kuch karna hai, kuch disha mein jana hai. If you can wake up like that every day, I think there is no greater blessing than that. So because it keeps you driven. Other thing by being in this sector which I enjoy the most is that there are people like me who are around me. Okay. All of them, I mean, being in the company of highly inspired people. So this all of you will not realize now maybe. Once you go and work for a big corporation, right, you'll realize this. People who are sitting there, they are not happy faces. Arey yaar, kya hai? Everybody's cursing the job, everybody's looking at their time, when the boss will leave so that I can leave after him. Right when they see the watch, ki boss ka paayega, uske pehle we'll go to office, we'll deliver some quarter end ke kuch results kar denge, shortcut dhoond lenge har cheez ka. I mean that is wasting life according to me. But I mean it's like there's no purpose. First you're doing something to make somebody else happy, and okay you'll get the paycheck. But there's no passion there. Here everybody who has come and joined Youth for Sale has a lot of passion. It's a volunteer, right? They have a choice. They can do something else. Why are they here? They are here because they're motivated. So being in the company of such people 24/7. I think there cannot be a greater privilege than that. So that is the best part which keeps you motivated. All of them think like that. So it's very, very good to be in such a company of such people.
You opened Hindu students also, right? So was it for Hindu or
It's not for Hindu. I mean, we can take this question in detail. But if you understand the word Hindu in detail, I don't know if you know the history of the word Hindu. It comes from the word Sindhu, right? It's a geographical word, it's not a religious word. Right? Hindustan, Hindu Mahasagar, Hindustan Times which comes here. I just, we'll take that question later, but the idea is it's about the culture. Okay, it's about the land, it's about its history, it's about the heritage of the land. All of that in one word if you want to put it, it's about Hindu. Okay. So the whole goal of Hindu Students Council was to understand India. Its culture, its heritage, different things. So it was open for everyone. It's not a religious organization by any standard. I mean, someone tell me if it's the last one. It's the last one. Like, tell me. Bro, zor se bolo yaar, kya hai?
Sir,
short. And like, you can take example, like it's already been said that failed actors become directors, that sort of thing. So I think competition is best in the world, because unless and until we have competition, we'll never try to give our best shot. This is what I think.
Tell me one great thing which has happened out of competition. Any person, any company, anything which has done well because of competition. See, you can achieve more by competition. First innings mein itna score hua hai to, the person who's chasing wants to beat that score, right? Otherwise, there's no motivation to score, you might think. But that's not true. You think of any great thing which has happened in this world, it's not because of competition. It has happened out of free spirit. Theek hai, baaki there will be a lot of players who come around and try to beat you. But the greatest thing will not happen because of competition. That is my sincere belief. Because the best in you will not come through competition. The best in you will come when you do what you want to do. What is the best in you? So if you try to copy somebody and try to beat them, you will keep doing this, because the next you will do something else, then you try to beat that person. So this will keep going on. So it will only happen, the greatest things will happen when you do what you want to do. This is true for everybody. You take Gandhi, you take Martin Luther King, you take Steve Jobs, you take Sachin Tendulkar. None of Sachin Tendulkar did walk into the stadium to beat Ryan Lara, okay? He just went there to play out of his passion, right? Even if the team won, he's happy. Even if he scored a zero. So it's just like that. I mean, it's about totally different thing. It's about not about yourself. If you want to become great, that's what I believe. And understand what you are saying. Two companies, I want to beat other company. Two countries, I want to defeat them in the economic growth. All these things, thoughts might be there, which will motivate us to do more. But maybe India has some other parents which China does not have. When will we explore those? If we only think of competition, we'll never explore those. Right? Maybe we have different ways of doing things which China doesn't have. Right? It is good to go and beat China in their GDP growth, but we'll be out of the race if we don't think in a different way. So we have to think what our strengths are and work on them if you want to do well.
Alright, so there may be a few of you who still have questions, and there is still much more to learn from Mr. Shobhit Mathur. So I will urge you to please write a mail to him. And for now, I would ask Devanshi to thank Mr. Shobhit Mathur on behalf of IIT Kanpur.
Inspiring lecture. I now invite Professor D.P. Mishra to felicitate Mr. Shobhit Mathur with a shawl, memento, and a bouquet.
Properly, and it is a wonderful, one of the best countries in the world. entire world. And if you are really interested to do something, you can really join that organization. And I can tell you that website is www.awakemi.weebly.com. I'll just write down. Do you have a chat? www.awakemi.weebly.com. This is basically Awake Mother India. Actually, I think it is there. And this is going to be what my vision is. We want to have a movement across the entire country. Of course, it will take time. And I'm very happy to say that when I was a youth, our youth or my age, they were not that sensitive what you people are today. I'm having faith that our youth at this time can change this country, can make this country a best place in the entire world.